I'm David Romer, Chair of the Berkeley Economics Department. Welcome to the virtual celebration of our 2020 graduates. We're in a global pandemic that's affecting every one of us profoundly. But even in the midst of that, it's important to take a little while to acknowledge and celebrate the achievements of our remarkable graduates. In the jargon of economics, this event we're having today is a complement, not a substitute, for a live in-person graduation ceremony, which we will have at some appropriate point when it's safe to do so. I'm going to give a short introduction, which will be followed by brief messages from many members of our faculty. To the graduates, you've learned and accomplished an enormous amount in your time at Cal, and you have every reason to be proud of what you have done. I also hope you are grateful to your family and friends, to your guides and mentors, to your teachers in elementary school and through high school, and to everyone else who helped you get to where you are. And to those family members, friends, and other supporters, you should take pride in the achievements of the graduates and in your own role in supporting them along the way. The students we're celebrating today are graduating from the Economics Department of the University of California, Berkeley. And of all the universities in the world and of all the majors, it's hard to beat being a Berkeley economics major. With regard to the Berkeley part of that, Berkeley is simply the best university in the world, period. It's justly renowned, of course, for its remarkable contributions to research and to the advancement of knowledge, including its 22 Nobel laureates, five of whom, I can't help but note, have been in economics. But it's also an amazing teaching university where world-class researchers share their knowledge and passion with students who are talented, hardworking, and eager to take advantage of what Berkeley has to offer. And throughout its history, Berkeley has demonstrated over and over again that although, as we economists are fond of pointing out, trade-offs are everywhere, the idea that there's a trade-off between diversity or inclusion on the one hand and excellence on the other is a false one. Rather, diversity and inclusion on all dimensions are critical sources of excellence. With regard to the economics part of being a Berkeley economics major, my own completely unbiased view is that economics is the best possible field of study in college. It deals with issues of critical importance. It provides a powerful and flexible framework for thinking about an enormous range of questions, and it equips you with invaluable tools for evaluating the evidence for and against competing hypotheses. So it provides a critical set of general skills that expand your mind and are of lifelong importance. At the same time, and not at all coincidentally, economics gives you practical knowledge and skills that are of immediate value when you head out into the labor market or pursue further education. That puts economics in the perfect sweet spot between training one's mind in the most profound sense and being immediately useful, and that combination makes it the ideal field to study. And the two pieces together, Berkeley and economics, have a unique synergy. The Berkeley Economics Department has a remarkable number of exceptional teachers teaching courses that are intellectually exciting, demanding, and mind-expanding. And our students' talents, curiosity, and dedication bring out the best in their instructors and in one another, leading to an education that's unmatched anywhere. So we look forward to seeing you back in Berkeley live and in person for a proper graduation ceremony, and I hope on many other occasions. In the meantime, congratulations on graduating from the best department of the best world's best university. Take care and best wishes.
Hi, everybody. It's Professor Olney. I wanted to take this minute to wish you a heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2020. I know it's been a heck of a ride for y'all, some ups and downs and a whole lot in between. I thought I'd tape mine outside so you can see the background here. I got Mount Tam behind me. If nothing else, I know this semester's ending really rough, but try to remember the incredible views and the beauty of campus. Remember all of the things that you learned and the ways in which you grew and you stretched and you changed. Remember that you will always, always be a golden bear, and nobody can ever take that away from you. So I wish you all the best. Celebrate with your families. Have a wonderful day. We will gather somewhere, somehow, to celebrate you, just not this month. And so y'all be well. Congratulations. Go Bears.
Hello, my name is Andres Rodriguez Clark. Congratulations on graduating from Berkeley Economics. It goes without saying that this is an extraordinary year. There is, of course, the lack of the usual commencement celebration and having to party with your computer. But more importantly, you're graduating during very challenging times. And I trust that your Berkeley education will serve you very well in dealing with those challenges. The world is going to change in the following years, and it makes me very hopeful to know that you will be part of that change. I wish you the best of luck in the following years, and go Bears!
Congratulations, you have just graduated from one of the top economics departments in the world at one of the weirdest times to graduate. I recently heard someone interviewed from China who said something simple but I found profound, which was that the coronavirus had taught him the difference between what was truly important and what wasn't. I think it may have done that for me, and I hope it does that for you. And I hope it does nothing worse than that for you or your family. And I also hope that Berkeley and your experience here turns out to be one of the good things that you cherish in your life. You'll always have a home at Berkeley. Be safe and be well.
Let me start with congratulations to everyone. That's the most important message of all, of course. Commencement is many people's favorite time of year. It's my favorite time of year. We get to see both our undergraduates and our PhD students parade across the stage. You get to hear us mispronounce your names. We get to hear your parents celebrate by banging drums and tooting horns. Much of that will be missing this year, but I would hope only temporarily. We're having commencement in our minds. I think we should all make a vow to have an actual physical commencement back in Berkeley, say in 5 years' time. And if that one works well and we have fun doing it, we can have it again in 25 years' time. So congratulations to all our graduates. Congratulations in absentia to their supervisors. And I look forward to seeing you in person in 5 years. And who knows, maybe again in 25.
Hello, everyone. This is Stephen Bianchi. I have taught at various times Econ 101A, Econ 139, which is financial economics, which is a course that I started in spring of 2017, Econ 140, of course, and last fall I taught Econ 142, which is applied econometrics. Econ 140 is a pretty big class. I've had the pleasure of having many of you in my classes, and I just want to say congratulations on your graduation. I know this transition from being an undergrad to being let loose in the world can be a little tricky. I have to say, in my case, I didn't really manage it all that well, but hopefully you'll do better. I'm sure you will. In any case, it's been an honor and a privilege to have each and every one of you in my classes. And I wish you the best going forward. I'm sorry that the semester kind of got cut short in terms of in-person classes. Hopefully the kind of rest of the semester is okay, at least. So please, good luck with everything, and please don't hesitate to get in touch in the future. Okay, cheers.
Graduating econ majors, congratulations. There is one thing you need to know as you go out into this COVID-addled world. You rock. Keep calm and carry on.
Congratulations on all you've accomplished here and all the ways you've challenged yourself. You know, universities are really special places because they're built around the power of ideas rather than the idea of power. And so best of luck to you as you graduate and take your next step. And I hope you carry with you a love for the power of ideas wherever you go.
Members of the class of 2020, congratulations. that we are all still largely locked down trying to keep coronavirus from killing more than 0.5% rather than the 3-5% of America we fear, that does not mean this is not a great and impressive milestone, an accomplishment and achievement for you. Be proud and be happy. And let me add one more thing, speaking not as a professor, but as a boomer, one of those in the generation born between 1950 and 1970 that are now retiring, starting back in 2012 or so. We pass you the baton in this world. We charge you with a task, to run faster and do more good for the world than we have. Good luck.
Hi, everyone. I'm Emi Nakamura from the Economics Department. I just want to say to the class of 2020, congratulations. We're so proud of all that you've accomplished.
Hi, I'm Hillary Hoynes, and I'm here to offer my congratulations to the class of 2020. I want to give a special shout out to my two undergraduate thesis advisees, you know who you are, as well as my amazing PhD students who are finishing up this year. I have to admit, I'm really going to miss the ceremony and the celebration, the baking heat or freezing cold at the Greek, but that doesn't take away from your incredible accomplishments. Congratulations.
Hey everyone, congratulations. Now you're Berkeley economists. I'm sure it'll make us proud. And to those of you that took my macro class, I love teaching you guys. You were the best.
Dear graduates, congratulations. You did it. I've had the pleasure of teaching some of you in my class on inequality. And I just want to say it's been such a pleasure. I think you have inspired me. You have been so passionate in my class. And I'll really keep this experience dearly with me as I go on. I'm sure that all of you are going to do very well in life. Both professionally and in private. And if I'm allowed to give one life advice, being a bit older than you, I think many graduates find that their first job is disappointing, right? You get out there, you have all of this positive energy that now you're going to transform the world, and then you meet the world and you don't feel that it butches or that it moves as fast as you would like it to move. And I think my advice is, please stick with it. Try to not just change direction at the first sight of resistance. Try to actually stay put and do the best you can. And I think that you'll then find that surprisingly fast you can actually make a positive impact. I think you're amazing, and I wish you all the best, and please reach out if you have anything you want to discuss or just to let me know how you're doing.
Hi all, Ray Hawkins here. First and foremost, my heartfelt congratulations on your graduation. With two fire seasons and a pandemic, yours has indeed been a most interesting Berkeley experience. Graduation is a time of reflection. And now more than ever, I encourage you to look beyond our current inability to meet in person and to reflect on the good experiences and uplifting friendships of your undergraduate career. For those of you who were in my courses, it was a professional privilege and personal pleasure to be your instructor. And to the class of 2020 more generally, my best wishes for your success in life, and go Bears!
Hi, I'm Christina Romer, and I just wanted to say congratulations to all our graduates. I know this is not the commencement that any of us hoped for or expected, but it's still a very special occasion. So congratulations, we're so proud of what you've accomplished. It's been an honor to be your teachers. And so enjoy this day. Thank you to all the families for supporting your graduates. And have a wonderful summer and stay safe, and we'll all get through this.
Congratulations, 2020 economics graduates. My name is Ted Miguel. I'm a professor here in the Department of Economics. I'd like to congratulate all of you, the undergrads, the PhD students, for finishing your degree and graduating from one of the world's leading economics departments. You should be very proud of yourself and very proud of all the hard work that went into your accomplishments. I'd also like to congratulate parents and other relatives, family and friends who are also celebrating with the graduates today. A lot of your hard work went into these accomplishments as well. I know that I personally would love for all of us to be able to celebrate together and share this moment together. Unfortunately, this year that can't happen, but I hope there will be a chance in the future for all of us, the faculty, the students, the staff, families and friends in the economics department, to celebrate your accomplishments in person. Until then, stay safe and healthy and be well. Again, congratulations.
Hi, students. This is Ulrike Marmendier, and I put on my full regalia because I wanted to send you very special congratulations in this very special graduating year 2020. You guys are amazing. It's been a pleasure to have you. And I hope that you're going to take away from this very special graduation year that you're the generation of those with the most resilience, the most future and forward-looking skills and abilities to adapt. And I just wanted to send you congratulations, all the best wishes, stay strong and stay in touch.
Hi everyone, and congratulations to the undergraduates and the PhD that you finished your course of studies at Berkeley. You're on to the next step of life. My name is Stefano Della Vigna. I taught some of you intermediate micro, some of you behavioral economics, and most of you, neither of those two. But I want to greet you with four hats to as a symbol, I think, of the path you've taken. The first one you'll see doesn't quite fit me, but this hat is a hat of a brain to remind ourselves how smart you guys are. And with all the parts of your brain that make who we are, it doesn't fit me because that's what happens when you steal your middle schooler's science project. The second one is a sailor hat. Because we are sailing into unknown, uncharted waters with COVID-19. But we kind of all learn from each other the courage to do things that we hadn't done before, like online classes and all the kind of adjustments while sequestering from home. The third one is my beloved Cal hat, and I hope you will wear it as long as I have. It loses its color, but I hope none of us forget that we want to go Bears. And finally, most importantly, your graduation hat. And I hope that this is going to be a day of joy, even given the fact that we can't have a commencement together. Go Bears!